All right, here's the best part about Marissa here. Ms. Hermer, of course, you know from one of the ladies of London, and with a fantastic chef we'll talk and introduce him in just a moment. She has offered to help carpool from West LA to the new restaurant location in West Hollywood, which is required. Chef Michael Fiorelli is here too. Nice to see you both. All right, we know you from reality TV.
Yes.
And in reality TV, you and your husband had this restaurant in London.
Yes.
And now you're here. The Draycott, of course, is part of Palisades Village. We're familiar with that. And now restaurant number two.
Restaurant number two, Olivetta, which we opened just 2 weeks ago, actually.
Yep.
And we've had incredible feedback, and we're having a lot of fun. And I'm eating the best food I've ever had in my entire life. So thank you for that.
I think you just need to get out more. But
So, Chef, how does that work? So she has this high profile.
Yep.
They're experienced restaurateurs.
Where do you
come in?
It's, you know, I hate to use this word, but it's really, I think it was serendipitous the way we met. They are experienced restaurateurs. So for them to be looking for a chef and myself to be available at the time, it just kind of all came together. And then we probably wound up becoming friends before anything else, and now family, and it's just a perfect fit.
It was love at first bite.
Love at first, there we go. And so what does one do? Do we sit down? Is it like the way one would write a script or something? We figure out what it's going to be?
Yeah, I think it's probably, I mean, it's very much sort of a conversation that we've been having for months.
Probably more sharing of ideas, goals, vision, things like that. And when those things line up, and it just, you know, there's that connection.
What a beautiful.
And visits to farmers
like
markets.
Yeah.
All of that.
Wow.
And so you think of a mood or what? I mean, is there sort of a log line to describe it? Do you know what I mean?
How you want to feel. How do we want to feel when we're in this space?
Right.
And that has to do with the decor and the employees and the guests and obviously the food.
So how do we want to feel when we're in?
Yeah.
The restaurant. Yeah. What is
like
that?
We don't want to leave.
Oh, okay.
Like you're on vacation somewhere.
All right.
Yeah.
Ah. And it did look like that.
People always. So here you are, this elegant person. People say running these restaurants is 24/7. It is one headache after another.
Oh, she's a tyrant.
Just for the right. Chef.
Is it only for the chef?
No,
what about
it's
for
a
you?
Team. It's a
no,
team
no,
effort.
For sure. I think for Michael sure. and I are always texting each other at either midnight if we're not in the kitchen eating together or 6 a.m. It is definitely 24 hours, but it's something that. I think it's something that it's in your blood. It's a passion. I never feel like I'm going to work. I don't feel like I have a job. I'm just having fun the whole time. It truly is a wonderful time.
All right, what do we have in front of us? Which apparently is edible.
Yes, it is.
Yeah. It's not only edible at the restaurant, but on TV too.
Yeah.
A few different things just to show you a little bit of the kind of the style of the restaurant. So here you have, this is our toasted sourdough bread, house-made butter.
Oh, wow.
You can have this as the chef's board all together. You can order everything separately, a little burrata cheese and serrano ham, some manchego cheese. We pickle our vegetables in-house. This is a crudité, which is kind of fun. We do two layers of roasted garlic hummus, a little French onion dip. We make a soil with olives and cashews, and then just always changing fresh vegetables.
Soil.
So you want to dip those all the way around. Yeah.
Hang on. Keep going.
Okay. our chopped kale salad, kind of a California meets Italian salad. A big part of what we do, we have a big ethos and a California sensibility. So sourcing from local markets and getting things close to home. So this is kind of an Italian chopped salad with California ingredients and a grilled Spanish octopus. Very classic, you know, the same way you'd get it in Spain. Potatoes, chorizo, peppers, salsa verde, preserved lemon.
Before it goes on the table, does everything pass your lips?
I've eaten all of these things for the last 3 months, and I'm looking at it right now, and for breakfast, I want it again. It is so good. Yes, yes, for sure.
And you're obviously not a lay person, but not a professional chef. Do you welcome the opinions from?
100%. I mean, especially when they're good. Right. Especially when the feedback is positive. You know.
Yeah.
No less than Christina Pascucci, scheduled to go to the restaurant. So if you're getting people like her, it's working.
My friends went last week. They loved it.
Oh,
they were just
so
raving about you. So
we'll see you next week.
Yeah,
or this
I'll
week.
Be there.
Olivetti is in West Hollywood. It's on Melrose, as of course it has to be. Open from 5 p.m. until late daily. Reservation via Resy or the website there. You can learn more about the restaurant. Chef Marissa, nice to see you both. Thanks for
thanks so much
morning.
For having us. Great
we
to
are going
to
gobble, and we'll be
yes,
back
we
in
are.
Just a minute.
Yeah.
Now, Mark walks right
over.
No plans to make a stop. Last time.